Hi everybody, my name is Cihan Topal. I will present you my presentation in this video. It is my homework at Introduction to Nanoscience and Nanotechnology Lecture. I will start with introduction. Nanotechnology in textiles. Nanotechnology is defined as the attestation of structures with at least one dimension of nanometer size for the construction of materials, devices or systems with novel or significantly improved properties due to their nanosize. Nanotechnology can best be described as activities at the level of atoms and molecules that have application in the real world. Nanoparticles commonly used in commercial products are in the range of 1 to 100 nanometer. Nanotechnology is increasingly attracting worldwide attention because it is widely perceived as offering huge potential in wide range of end uses. The unique and new properties of nanomaterials have attracted not only scientists and researchers but also businesses due to their huge economical potential. Nanotechnology also has real commercial potential for the textile industry. This is mainly due to the fact that conventional methods used to impart different properties to fabrics often do not lead to permanent effects and will lose their functions after laundering or wearing. Nanotechnology can provide high durability for fabrics because nanoparticles have a large surface area to volume ratio and high surface energy, thus presenting better affinity for fabrics and leading to increase in durability of the function. In addition, a coating of nanoparticles on fabrics will not affect their breathability or hand feel. Therefore, the interest in using nanotechnologies in the textile industry is increasing. The first work on nanotechnology in textiles was undertaken by Nanotex, a subsidiary of the United States-based Burlington Industries. Later, more and more textile companies began to invest in the development of nanotechnologies. Coating is a common technique used to apply nanoparticles onto textile. The coating compositions that can modify the surface of textiles are usually composed of nanoparticles as surfactant in ingredients and care medium. Several methods can apply coating onto fabrics, including spraying, transparent printing, washing, rinsing, and padding. Of these methods, padding is the most commonly used. The nanoparticles are attached to the fabrics with the use of feather adjusted to a suitable pressure and speed, followed by drying and curing. However, there is some recent work done in nanotechnology-based textile. In this paper, we have made an attempt to give better understanding and clear overview of the concept of nanotechnology in the textile industry. The properties impart to textiles using nanotechnology include water repellence, soil improvement of durability, and so on has been reviewed thoroughly in this paper. Hence, there are various potential application of nanotechnology in the textile industry. Only some of the well-known properties imparted by nanotreatment are critically highlighted in this paper. Role of nanotechnology in textiles. The textile industry certainly has the biggest customer base in the world. Therefore, the advances in the customer-oriented products will be the main focus for future nanotechnology applications, and the textile industry is expected to be one of the main beneficiaries. However, it goes without saying that there certainly are some limitations and unknown health risks pertaining to the rapid development and growth of nanotechnology and also their end-use products. For example, it's extremely difficult and complex to process carbon fibers of smaller than 200 nanometer with traditional textile practices and product procedures. Nanotechnology in textile is used in the different places. A wide range of fiber size or thickness can be utilized in textile processing. Ordinary and fine linear textile fibers range from 100 to 200 micrometer in diameter and are produced by established dry wet dry. Jet melt spinning through spinnerets 1 to 100 micrometer in diameter. Nanofibers of diameters in nanometer range are mostly manufactured by electro spinning process. Although there are also other methods, there are many ways in which the surface properties of fabric can be manipulated and enhanced by implementing appropriate surface finishing, coating and or altering techniques using in nanotechnology. A few representative applications of fabric finishing using nanotechnology are schematically displayed in figure 2. Nanotechnology provides a plenty of efficient tools and techniques to produce this desirable fabric attributes, mainly by engineering modifications of the fabric surface. For example, the fermentation of fluid weighting towards the development of water-stain-resistant fabrics has always been of great concern in textile manufacturing. Wettability. Wettability is one of the most important properties of solid surface and the contact angle has been commonly used to characterize the surface wettability. A surface with a water contact angle, the angle larger than 150 degrees and low sliding angle is usually called a superhydrophobic surface. Superhydrophobic surfaces have attracted much interest because of their potential practical applications such as anti-sticking, anti-contamination and self-cleaning coating. The mechanism is similar to the lotus effect occurring in nature. Lotus plants have a superhydrophobic surfaces which are rough and textured. Once water droplets fall into them, water droplets build up and if the surface drops slightly, will roll off. As a result, the surfaces stay dry even during heavy shower. Furthermore, the droplets pick up small particles of dirt as they roll and so the leaves of the lotus plant keep clean even during light. Here is the view. We can use nanotechnology in textile in different parts of life. Some of them water resilience, anti-static properties, wrinkle resistance, strength enhancement, ultraviolet blocking, computing, antibacterial odor control, sensors, optical displays. I will try to present you. Water and oil repellents. Water repellents can be imparted to textile by forming nanowhiskers consisting of hydrocarbons that are three orders of magnitude smaller than a typical cotton fiber. Nanowhiskers are integrated with within the fabric to create a pitch positive. Analogous to the lotus effect, the spaces between individual whiskers are smaller than a drop of water but larger than water molecules, producing a high surface tension that allows the water to remain on the surface. The whiskers maintain the breathability as they permeate gases. Water ripples can also be induced through rotation of 3D surface structures on the fabric by adding galvanizing additives or coating the textile with nanoparticulate. For example, audio frequency plasma of fluorocarbon derivatives can be applied to coat cotton fibers with nanoparticulate particulates. By producing roughness on the surface of the fabric, superhydrophobicity can be created without affecting abrasion resistance and softness of the fabric. Silica nanoparticles in combination with water repellent agents can also be utilized to impart hydrophobicity into textiles. SI2 were synthesized right via a soft gel process. Cotton fabrics treated with both SI2 MPS and water repellent agent first produced contact angles above 130 degrees. SiO2 MPS could be coated over cotton in the presence of perfluorocetyl state, quaternary ammonium silane coupling agent to produce hydrophobicity. While the SiO2 MPS spread roughness on the surface of cotton fibers, PQASCA lowered the surface energy. The resulting textile exhibits water repellence with a water contact angle of 145 degrees. Oil repellency of the fabric also improved, showing a 131 degree contact angle for a diluted methane droplet on the fabric surface. Another study, amplific genus micro NFS, were chemically immobilized on textile surfaces. 20 wild microparticles bound between fibers MPS attached to the fiber surface. Genus particle immobilized textiles showed water repellence. Bio-inspired design has also motivated investigation of water repellent materials. For example, duck feathers consist of multi-scale structures having breathing oil to repel water. The mixture of structures of duck feathers was simulated by coating cotton and polyester textile with cetosan using a surface solution precipitation method followed by modification with a silicone compound to achieve a low surface energy. Figure 2A shows a scanning electron microscope image of polyester and cetosan treated polyester having nanosized toughness on the surface. Cetosan treated polyester textiles provided flexibility and water repellence. Lotus leaf nanostructures also inspired biomimetic studies for application in textiles. Cotton fibers were coated with pristine and surface modified carbon nanotubes. To mimic the nanostructure of cotton sleeves, the resulting cotton fabrics had contact angles greater than 150 degrees. Another study that was inspired from cotton sleeves involved the development of nanocotton to create hydrophobic textiles. The nanocoating consisted of its epoxy-containing poly and SiO2 MPS for the initial surface modification and generation of the preliminary active layer. polymers with different functional groups called the grafted on the reactor oil. Oil represent textile have also been produced. Polyester fabric could be coated with silicon nanofilaments and treated with plasma fluorination to import superabsorbent properties to textiles. The produced fabric samples had an oil repellency rate of 80 and repelled organs. Hydrophobic and odorphobic properties could be similar simultaneously imparted to textiles. For example, cotton fibers were impregnated with SiO2 particles to produce a dual size surface roughness, followed by hydrophobization with poly resulting in static water contact angle of 155 for a droplet. To induce olefobicity, the SiO2 particles on the fibers were treated with perfluorophilic chain, and which was demonstrated by static contact angle of 140 and roll off angle of 24 degree for oil droplets. Non-static properties. Synthetic fabrics such as polyester and nylon have a wide static charge because they are not hydrophobic. On the other hand, cellulosic fibers limit the static charges due to their high moisture contact. I will continue in the main subject about smelling socks. It is here. Antibacterial properties, Ag, TiO2 and Cyano. MPS can be utilized to impart antibacterial and fungidial properties to textiles. Ag MPS have a large surface area that increase their contact with bacteria and fungi. The antiseptic mechanism of Ag is based on reacting with proteins in these organisms and adversely affecting their cellular function in inhibiting cell growth. They also reduce respiration, limiting the activity of the basal metabolism of the electron transfer system, and substrate transport into the cell membrane. When Ag contact with moisture or bacteria, they adhere to the cell wall and membrane. While the Ag in their metallic state are inert, they ionize in the presence of moisture. The Ag plus ions are reactive and they diffuse through the cell wall and membrane into the cytoplasm. Ag plus ions bind to sulfur-containing proteins on the cell membrane to structurally change the cell wall. These structural changes result in the release of the cellular components of extracellular fluid due to the changes in the ostomic pressure. Additionally, the Ag plus ions bind the phosphate-containing proteins to the condensed DNA, leading to a reaction with thiol group proteins to cause cell death. They also suppress the function of enzymes and inhibit the cell to produce ATP. Ag slow the growth and multiplication of bacteria and fungi that are involved in odor creation and itchiness. Figure 2F shows cotton fibers treated with Ag. For example, Ag MPS can be applied to socks to prevent the growth of bacteria and fungi. The antimicrobial efficacy of Ag additives depend on the concentration, surface area, and the release rate of the Ag plus ions. Ag containing textile can release dissolved and particulate Ag into washing liquid in the first cycle. In the fabrics comprising Ag metal, oxidation from Ag to AgU to AgI is required for releasing Ag plus ions in solution. 70 ion release from Ag and PS is a cooperative oxidation process involving dissolved oxygen and protons to produce peroxide intermediates and complete reactive dissolution. The presence of oxygen is essential for the release of dissolved Ag through the surface oxidation of Ag and PS. The ion releases rate increase as the temperature is increased and the pH is decreased. For example, Ag released 0.3 milligram dissolved Ag after 24 hour incubation in air saturated solution at pH 5.68. The release of dissolved Ag was 0.6 and 0.1 milligram at pH 4 and 8 after 24 hour incubation, respectively. Additionally, the change in ionic strength has a negligible effect on the release kinetics. TiO2 MPS can also be utilized to impact textiles with antibacterial properties. Upon elimination with light with energy higher than its band gap, TiO2 as a photocatalyst has the ability to have its electrons jump from the valence band to the conduction band. The electron and electric cloud pairs form on the surface of the photocatalyst, where the electrons and oxygens from CO2 and the positive electrons and water create hydroxyl radicals. The unstable substances on the surface of the photocatalyst are oxidized into carbon dioxide and water. Through this mechanism, the photocatalyst decomposes organic matter, including other molecules, bacteria, and viruses. The catalytic activity of TiO2 and PS has been utilized in textiles to provide antibacterial properties. The photocatalytic activity might be improved by creating TiO2, SiO2 nanocomposite or out-of-put TiO2 nanocomposites in cotton fabrics with self-cleaning properties. The photocatalytic activity might be improved by creating TiO2, SiO2 properties. Furthermore, ZNO behaves similar to TiO2 to produce antibacterial properties. ZNO and PS coated onto textiles show certain properties in the presence of gram negative Escherichia coli and aerobic gram-positive Staphylococcus aureus. Additionally, SiO2 and Ag with core corona structures were electrostatically assembled onto cotton surfaces with high packing density to impart antibacterial properties to fabrics. The coronas of MPS can be loaded with antibacterial moieties such as quaternary ammonia salts as well as metal coating on cotton fabrics. Discussions focusing on self-cleaning and antimicrobial nanomaterials in textile can be found elsewhere. Here are some applications and which nanomaterials is used inside the applications. Uh, My presentation is finished here. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.